Today we're gonna hike the Spring Garden and railroad tracks in search of where the ice house may have been located. See if we can't find some artifacts. Here we go. Just gonna slowly walk along. And helps to check a lot of these debris piles. A lot of time when they're scraping back from working on the railroad tracks. So we got a Pepsi bottle. Pepsi. Don't know how old that is, so do some research when I get home and we'll find out. Piece of milk glass right there. It's kind of a Pond's or a Pond style facial cream. Very popular 1920s and newer. Like another piece of yeah, it is. It's another piece of the same jar. About 20 feet away from where I picked up the last one. Man, this is crazy. A dead animal in a plastic bag. Dead chicken. That's what it is. Somebody's free roaming rooster, looks like. Sad. It's hard to find stuff when it's mixed in with this kind of bedrock. Stuff tends to get broken up. I'm really, really close to the highway here, so the chances of finding old stuff this close to the road is pretty slim. Take one quick look on this little hill right here and we'll start heading inland. So we're facing east. It's heading into town. The original rail ran east of town to the other side of Amelia, and this direction looking west runs out by DeLand train station off of Old New York. So we're gonna start hiking in, and let's see what kind of discovery we can make today. Part of a Coke bottle. I can tell by the skirt ridge on it right there. I got hundreds and hundreds of these pieces and tons of full-size bottles that have been damaged in my collection. There we go. I always like finding this kind of glass. I thought it was an insulator. It may be an insulator. It's got some writing on it. Can't exactly make out what it says, but when I get home later, I'll hit it under a loop and see if I can't see what it says there. This is cool looking. What is it? Oh man, this is great. So what we have here is a beautiful antique porcelain quick disconnect. Kind of like a main circuit breaker. This is really cool. It's the first time I've ever seen one like this. Very cool find. Sure, it's very old too. Okay, here's a, just laying on the ground like there's a, it's a modern insulator. Somebody threw it over the fence. It's broken. But it's usable for art. Definitely usable for art. We got right there. Right there is a piece of brick. Got the feeling it's from one of the original buildings. So, now all the property, I'm presuming the ice house is probably over there somewhere. It's all on the Duke Energy property now. But there were businesses and stuff along the tracks here. There's a wooded area right there. In my experience, that the wooded areas that are left standing around the land are hiding old home and business sites. Right there is actually, it's like an old business right there that was right along the railroad tracks. Kind of cool. Have to investigate that on the return trip down back to the car, going back east again. Okay, right there we've got another piece of green glass. I'm presuming it's probably a Coke bottle, not an old one. It's pretty thick. Glass on the old ones was like really, really thick. That's a modern soda bottle, probably within the last 20 years. A neck. An old carriage bolt. See, it's got a square edge on that. I found a punch that they used to use to make those holes. It was a tapered punch. Very sharp point square. And it went up to about a 2-inch square hole, which would have been one very large carriage bolt. But interestingly enough, when they punched the hole in the metal for these kind of parts, it was done when the iron was still glowing red. And it took a very precise swing to drive the punch to make the correct size hole to receive that square. And these are called carriage bolts because they used them on carriages, like horses' carriages. And it was made square right there so the bolt didn't turn and aid to the, you know, loosening up because carriages would bounce around and all. It's like another piece of insulator glass. Always grab the blues. Blues are a very popular color. It's hard to keep any kind of blue glass in stock. There's another old brick right there. A fired piece. Fired piece. This is a brick telling me that there was commercial interest of some sort. There's another modern insulator. Oh, now wait a minute now. It's already broken, so. I don't think that drop's gonna hurt it any. That's kind of sweet. It's a small one. I've never seen one that little. Kind of cool. That's kind of strange. Look. Some kind of training dummy. Sitting on top of a old hand cart. That's kind of strange. You never know what you're going to come across when you're out exploring off the beaten path. That is a little strange for sure. It's tapered, so my guess is it's for some kind of pipe. Oh, yeah, there's the pipe right there. Don't know how old it is. Another old piece of brick right there. Generic though. There's no brick maker mark on it. Now it shows a pond in the photograph that I saw. Close to the ice house. Presuming they were pulling the water to make the ice out of there. So, is that the pond right there? Interesting, it might be. Oh, look at this. He died walking. Yeah, his feet are still out. Maybe he got whacked by the train. It's a green glass. I'm guessing it's fairly new. I don't think any more than 20 years old. Yeah, case closed. There you go. Same piece of glass right there. And this is a I'm thinking ginger ale bottle. Maybe 1990s. Would have had a styrofoam label on it. Probably ginger ale. Kind of cool. Part of a hinge, old metal hinge. Add that to our collection. Modern bottle. Look, somebody threw a tire here, and these trees are growing up through the middle of it. I'm not going to be carrying that out of here. I just found a garbage heap right up against the tracks. Yep. Taking a minute here and get these little burrs off of me. Little seed pods, they stick to everything and then they get itchy. So let's see what we got here. Right up against the tracks and stuff's come spilling over the top. And years of the weathering. And so that's like 1970s right there. That's almost all of it. We'll pick that up on the way out. Let's see if I can find the missing fragment. Yeah, a lot of times the missing fragments went in the trash. It's the piece they picked up and threw in a garbage can, and the rest of the stuff got dumped over the hill in the woods. We got a Bay City, Michigan Coke bottle base. What's that? Oh, mellow yellow. Yep, look, mellow yellow. Definitely a 1970s bottle. I'll take that bottom. Look. Not quite intact, but coffee cup. And it's just piles of trash everywhere. Hard to tell what this was. Some kind of tin. It's rusted. Been out here at least a day or two. LOL, as they would say. Slice. That's kind of cool. Return for deposit. That's how you know it's like 1970s. This is somebody's burn pit here. What's this? Oh, get out of town, that's fat. It's a light bulb. And it's completely melted flat. That's kind of bad to the bone. Like, seriously bad to the bone. Look, there's another one that started. I mean, think about the odds of the light bulb not exploding, being it's under vacuum, and then the vacuum gets under high temperature. So, kind of cool. Look at that. A miniature test tube. That's kind of strange. Always amazes me sometimes is finding some of the most fragile pieces of glass, you know, ceramics and pottery, you know, that survive all this. Survive the fire pit, survive being thrown in a trash mound for 30, 40, 50, 100 years plus, and still being intact. I'm guessing Cremora, very popular in the 1970s, stuff was everywhere, offices and homes. Cheap powder chemical that was supposed to replace cream or milk for your coffee. Another test tube right there, a miniature test tube. Another test tube. Looks like it might be silver. I'll take that home and clean that up. We'll see. Another test tube. Hike up and look at this fallen tree. Sometimes bottles get trapped up in the roots. And when the tree falls, it upturns the earth. And sometimes you look out and find some cool stuff. See, this is what I'm talking about. Look. Look at this right here. See, that brick was trapped up inside that root. Good mortar too, look. Pretty strong. Not seeing anything other than that brick. See that there is cinder. And cinders, what remains after they burn coal in a train. The coal turns into cinder. And there was so much of this at one time that it was used for roadbeds and, believe it or not, if you can imagine using this on a running track at school. They used to do that up until the 1970s. They were still cinder tracks spotted around the country. I actually, when I was younger, ran on one. And it was a trip. Especially if you slipped. Plastics. The freaking plastics everywhere. The artifacts of our society today, it's going to be a lot of plastic composites. Alright, that's the end of our westbound trip. Looking on the south side of the tracks, and we're gonna go east and do a little scan of the east side of the tracks. And a lot of railroad debris and a lot of people's construction debris. There's an old tree fort right there. Tough spotting stuff and this kind of terrain, little chunky rocks from them having just changed out the railroad ties recently, and leaves everywhere. You're hard pressed to find any artifacts around this side. Alright, this is interesting. Right here is, I'm seeing midden. I'm thinking that's midden. Is it midden? Not sure what it is. It's one very large hill of a concrete looking stuff. And I mean, it's a big hill. It's not Midden, though. It's like something got torn down and they just pushed it all into a pile right here. There's some more of that debris pile. It's a good sized mound too, as you can see. actually looks like Revere ware, but they've lost the most of the copper cladding. Probably had a fire going right there and they burnt the copper cladding off of them. Two Revere ware pots. Nothing to rescue there. Tons and tons of plastic and more plastic and more plastic. That stuff ends up everywhere. You know, it blows around in the wind. Anytime it's in contact with water, it's sad how far plastic will travel. There's a way old piece of fencing. That right there is definitely 1920s or earlier. Tell by this design right here and by the twistings. See how they do the twist? This stuff was built to last. I mean, look, it's been sitting in water. I'm right at the end of a swamp. It's definitely got a rust line right here where it's been in and out of the water. Oh yeah, the mosquitoes can smell me for sure. So I'm gonna be making tracks here. And look at this old fence post. And this corner post is recycled railroad tie. Cans and bottles, plastic bottles. And for some reason, there's foam rubber cushioned all over the place out here. All right, that's actually styrofoam. I also see some brick out there. Intermittent pieces of brick. We know that they didn't float in from somewhere. In order for them to have gotten out there, the water table would have been much lower. It's old brick too. You can tell by how big the hole is for the cells. Definitely a good size. Cells today are only about that big on the bricks. That one's about like that. Looks like a 6x6. So interestingly enough, there appears to be a pond on each side of the tracks, just off of the truck route, Spring Garden. So it's hard to know if the photograph showing the ice house facing the trains is taken from where I'm standing now, or is the view looking that way from that side of the pond. It's hard to know. I have to bring it up on the satellite map and see if I can't pick out any distinguishing features. I suspect there was probably some kind of building here at one time because of this palm tree right here. This isn't just your standard. Look, there's another one right there. Almost as if this was marking a property line or something here. What do you say there, mallards? You got a beautiful home here. Yes, you do. Got a male and a female. big old GE insulator from something. Oh yeah, can you see all the lubber hoppers? Lots and lots of grasshoppers. There's a nice little insulator, broken, but got a market for this. Half pint. Half pint alcohol. Find lots of these everywhere. It's a pretty popular thing back in the day. Just get yourself a pint or a half a pint and wash your misery and sorrows away. There's an old insulator right there. Piece of one. That's old school. That would allow for a wire to pass through. Right there. And fastener. And then the wire. A lot of times there would be like where they would do a tie to tie the ground to the to a house or something. It'd be hooked up like that, and then they do a twist on it. And there's some piece of bullnose tile. It's hard to tell what that was. It's definitely fired.